Hi there, this is Noor Zibda, functional nutritionist and dietitian, and you're here because you want to learn something new to improve your health so you feel amazing. So let's get started. Today's video is about stomach acid. Nobody wants it, but it's actually good for you and really important, and I'm going to tell you why. So the acid is produced by the cells that line the stomach, and they have a very important function, is that they are the first step of digestion. So the acid is going to help you break down all the good proteins that you're eating so that you can absorb them. The acid will also help you absorb vitamin B12 because it comes attached to certain proteins, and without that acid, it stays bound to those proteins and it doesn't get absorbed at all in the intestine. You also need the acid to stimulate the pancreas to produce certain enzymes that help you absorb zinc and chromium and selenium and all these other important minerals. The acid is also important for absorbing iron. So if you don't have enough stomach acid, then you are missing out on all these nutrients, and the longer it goes, the more deficiencies that you may have. So you're not really what you eat. You are what you absorb and what you digest. So keep that in mind. Now the second role for stomach acid is that it keeps the acidity of the stomach really high, and that prevents pathogens and bacteria from growing. So when you don't have enough acid, just the bacteria is going to sit there and ferment and eat all this food and grow, and then you might have problems afterwards. So they can grow and cause gas and bloating and stomach pain and belching or burping. And if you feel like after you eat that you have that fullness or like a rock in your stomach, that can all be a problem related to too much bacteria in the stomach. So here's a reality shocker. If you have heartburn or reflux or acid, it is not because you have too much acid. It's actually because you don't have enough acid. So the food sits in your stomach, it rots, it gets fermented by these bacteria, and all these gases, they push up the stomach and they open up the muscle that is between your stomach and your esophagus. And then the stomach content goes up, and the esophagus does not have the lining that protects it from the acid, and that's how you feel the heartburn. So again, it's not that you have too much acid, it's that you have not enough acid. So what can you do about this? First of all, we all produce less stomach acid as we age. So in our 30s, we start to produce less of it. And if you're on any antacid medications, then you're making it worse. So this is a serious conversation that you want to have with your doctor. All these medications that suppress the acid or neutralize it can make you feel really bad long term. So they may be a temporary solution. They may remove the symptom, but then they don't remove the problem. So have a conversation with your doctor. Now you know. And if you don't believe me, go and do some research. There's lots of articles and information out there on stomach acid. Now, the second thing you can do is eat fewer carbohydrates. So we know that bacteria, they feed on carbs. So things like cereals and sugars and breads and pastas and all those things are really not so, that they're not going to provide a lot of nutrients. Cut back on this amount and see if it helps, because if you have less food for the bacteria, they may ferment less and then you may have improvement in your complaints or symptoms. And the third thing you can do is to boost your digestion. So you can do that by utilizing enzymes, and there are a variety of products that you can use. So here's when you have to be a little careful, is when you incorporate products on your own, you have to be a little careful about that. So one thing you can try naturally is raw apple cider vinegar, because it stimulates the cells in the stomach to produce the acid. There are a bunch of digestive enzymes products that I use in my practice. So some of them contain betaine HCl, which helps your stomach produce more acid. And then there are enzymes that don't have HCl, but have a variety of enzymes. And they may be a little better to tolerate if you have severe heartburn. So I will put the links for these products, but keep in mind that when you do something on your own, there's maybe some risk of making things worse before making them better. And so this is when I highly recommend that This is part of a comprehensive gut approach. And if you have been on any antacid medications for a long period of time, then you might need to take it slower and introduce few things that would heal the lining of the stomach and the esophagus before you introduce those enzymes. So just be a little careful. So three things that you can do. Don't start antacid medications, and if you're on them, talk to your doctor about tapering the dose. Eat fewer carbohydrates, and then boost your digestion with natural or supplement digestive enzymes. So if you know someone who is suffering from heartburn, make sure that they know about this. Share this video or tag them, and they'll be so much more empowered when they go talk to their doctors. And if you feel like this is something you're suffering from, definitely contact me, and I would be more than happy to see if we can work together and help you resolve this problem. And the last thing, if you like this video, just subscribe and tell others about what I'm doing here, and so that you don't miss new videos in the future. So that was it for today, and I will hope to see you next time.